So friends, like all we heard about the Genesis, the public relations company, I would like to ask Prema on why did you select PR as a line of business?
Why did I use this word Genesis? And you must be wondering, because people used to call me Mrs. Genesis when I used to go to collect my check from a client. The finance guy would say, Mrs. Genesis has come. They didn't know me as Sagar, you know. So they thought Genesis was my surname, because you put your surname onto, you know, all these businesses that you start. You'd like, Genesis means the beginning of life. This was beginning of my life, you know. And that's how the name Genesis came.
A couple of months back, we had participated in TOIFA, the Times of India Awards in Vancouver. And I was shocked to see that Genesis was the PR agency of Times of India. How can anybody become a PR agency of a news publication, and that too of Times of India? So that's the kind of the expertise that Genesis wields. Prema, we would like to know, in 2005, something dramatic happened in your life and in the life of Genesis. And a collaboration happened, a strategic alliance happened. You all got in a strategic alliance with Burson Marsteller.
Yeah, so basically we started this company, Public Relations, in the basement of a basement with, I had one peon, one colleague and myself. So this was a subject which was not known in India. So when somebody said, will you come and tell us what is public, how we can partner, how can we be a client of yours, because the country was opening up and people wanted to have badges. You know, we want a McKinsey, we need a public relations company and a financial consultant. So I said, so do you know what public relations is? No. But you want it? Yes. So I said, okay, so let's tell you first, what is public relations? Now, having done that, people started believing in what I was teaching them first. And then came the contract. So the one learning is that it's not about money. Money follows good work. And so it was never about how much I'm going to get out of a client. It is how much are you going to do for the client? What impact are you going to make? And I think maybe that's the reason why we grew faster. It is about getting clients, retaining clients, and growing the clients. And if you do that, your people, if you retain people, you grow with the people and let the people grow with you, then you are going to succeed. There's no other way. If you're looking purely at, okay, now I have to get so many million rupees, it's not going to happen. You can have a plan that this is what you want to achieve. But if it is the aim to just make money in services particular, if you're, creating soap and, surf and whatever else, that you can do for a consumer part. But when you're in a service industry, you have to provide value. And that was my learning. And now, why did I go to Burson Marsteller in New York? I wanted to leapfrog the learning. I did not want to start with ABC. I wanted to start with PQRS. I wanted to do what nobody else was doing. And why should we learn the hard way of doing mistakes? Let's go to New York. Let's go to a conference in Switzerland at that time. And I learned what they should not do, what we should not do, because they were making mistakes. So that was the one big thing for us, is that the leapfrogging of learning from Burson Marsteller. Harold Burson is 93 as of a few days ago. He's still alive. He still goes to office every day. And he still goes to clients and gives them advice. Coca-Cola is still his client for some 43 years. So it tells you something about a person who is up to date at 93, understands social media, and is giving advice as per this now, where the things have changed so much. So then I felt one day that we should partner with them so that globally we can learn faster, quicker, we can exchange people, that kind of thing. So that's how the partnership started. So I always say that you have to first get engaged, and obviously, and then get married. I didn't get engaged, I just got married, ran away. But but I do believe that you need an engagement. You do need to know each other well. The culture is more important. And though I met about 5-6 global firms, the ones that I really matched culturally was Burson Marsteller. And so we became affiliates. And then 5 years after that, we went into a relationship where they wanted to buy equity from us. So that's what happened.
Fantastic. I think this is a wonderful takeaway. Just leapfrogging your growth. Otherwise, in organic process, you take ages to reach that scale. So just, if you can beat them, join them. They are larger than you. Make them your partners. Do a strategic alliance. I think this is a good takeaway. The strategic alliance made her go to every part of the world. So automatically, you are tied up with an affiliation which has opened international doors to you. So any foreign clients coming into India, they are handled by Prema Sagar and her team. And any clients from India, if they want to do business abroad, I'm sure Burson Marsteller must be doing a brilliant job. So what is the difference that you create which attracts them to you and they retain their services with you?
So if you are going to develop a strategy in public relations, first and foremost, you must know the environment in which you're operating. So what is the economic and political and social environment? What is, supposing let's take an engineering company for example, what is it that they are doing and not doing? What is the policies of the government, first and foremost? So once you have all that background work done, then you say, okay, how will I take this client and make it different from everybody else? What are their strengths? What are their weaknesses? Internally, how are they in terms of, for example, their people? So you actually do an internal survey, and then you'd say, how are your people ready to be successful externally? So when you do internal communications, when you get everybody aligned, then only should you be doing external communications. And external communications could be talking to government, talking to media, talking to doctors, talking to engineers, talking to anybody who's the audience, who's the consumer, who are the people who support you in business. So unfortunately, a lot of the companies just do media relations. Media is one of the channels of communication. People with expertise are the other channels of communication. So you have to do a 360 degree to succeed. But for us, it is important. It could be 5 lakhs a month. It can be 2 lakhs a month. It means what is the service you're going to provide and what is it going to cost? And it is not, and what you're going to measure and as a result. So what we started in India was a measurement company to measure the impact of what you've done. You don't just want to say, oh, it came in the media. Did it go to the audience? If you are the audience and I'm telling somebody else in some other part of the city, it's of no use.
But there is also another first that your company has done, which is a concept called the live media room. So can you please explain to the audience of what is the importance?
So the live media room is a room like this. And you've got a whole wall of televisions and a whole wall of televisions, and there are people sitting in the middle. So if you're my client and I'm telling you tomorrow what happened today, you're going to say, you know, it doesn't help because that situation has passed. So in today's, it's everything is real time. Everything is here and now. Twitter is like going crazy. And then there's Facebook where there's this whole emotion coming out. And then there is all this LinkedIn and there's all the other viral videos which you make and all of that. So all of these things could be good, could be bad, could be ugly. So what we felt is that this is the only thing I'm really proud of is that this is the first in the world globally. So we call it the GBM newsroom. And what do? Is we are, when news is happening, it first hits online which means on websites, and it hits Twitter and social media. And then it goes to television. Now, in television, it's picking it up from online and social media. And they are writing breaking news. And they don't have the right breaking news. So now we do a ticker news. We do a ticker news. We do a breaking news. We send it out for that breaking news so that they get the right, you know, content. Because they are also competing with each other. They want to put out the information immediately. But sometimes they don't see that, you know, it's not quite right. And then it goes to print. And print means national, regional, international. Now you think, sitting in that room, how are you going to know all of this? So we've got groups of people who are sitting there, who are watching social media and letting you know, okay, client X, the policy has changed. We let them know real time. When news is breaking and it's not right, we must stop it immediately. It is in the New York Times within minutes, because it's online too. So we have to be real time. And so the complexity is huge, actually. It's no more just sending a press release.
And probably that must be addicting your customers to stay tuned to you. And probably this is not something that other agencies are doing. So it's a cutting edge technology for you to stay ahead of competition, isn't it?
Absolutely.
So how do you do talent management in your organization? You have got your own personal team of 275 professionals. So how do you do talent management with them? How do you motivate them? How do you retain them? And how do you give them directions to perform?
What I've changed around is that you need expertise. You can do any job, but what are you expert in? Are you an expert in nutrition? Is it that you understand technology? Do you understand brands, which is a completely different thing, doing brands? Do you understand engineering? In fact, we have a team that does only education. So then there is entertainment. We do Colors Channel, for example. That is another different way of doing PR and another kind of people who do it. So we ask people, what is it that makes you feel good? Do you feel good in healthcare? Do you feel in what? If you have expertise of media, or do you have expertise of strategy, or do you have expertise on a domain? Is the expertise about healthcare, or is it about technology? So we had turned everything upside down at the moment. And I know that this will succeed, because what clients want is important, and they want expertise. Do you understand my business is what the question is. And we want to say, no, let me tell you what I'll do for you. I don't think, you know, the service sector should be working like that. First, you have to commit to yourself before you even commit to anybody else, that I have to be proud of what I do. And so I must not fail. I just believe that we have to do good work. And we have the good people. And there's a saying in the organization that those who don't fit into this environment, and there are those, they get self-ejected in 3 months.
Okay. Oh, that's a nice method. That was pretty interesting. That's Prema Sagar for you, a very down-to-earth personality, who is doing a brilliant job nationally and internationally, who has been a successful entrepreneur. She rubs shoulders with the most powerful corporates in this country.